Hi class, today we're going to take a look at adding and subtracting rational expressions. And before we do that, we're going to take a flashback to what it's like to add and subtract just regular fractions, because our rational expressions are just fancy fractions, basically. So let's take a look at what if we wanted to add 4/5 and 2/3. The first thing that we would want to do is get common denominators, because right now, if we take a look at our 5 and our 3, they don't match, so we can't add until those match. So we look at the 5 and the 3, and the smallest value that goes in those both go into is 15. So we want to turn the 5 into a 15, and we do that by multiplying by 3. So I'll multiply the numerator and the denominator by 3. My numerator of 4 times 3 will turn the top of this fraction into 12. And in the denominator, multiplying the 5 times 3, I'll get a new denominator of 15. Now let's look at the second fraction. If you look at the second fraction, the denominator is 3. To build that up to a 15, I need to multiply it by a 5. But if I multiply it by a 5, I have to multiply the numerator of 2 by a 5. That gives me a new numerator of 10 and a denominator of 15. These denominators now match, so I can add straight across, and 12 times or plus 10 is 22. And we leave our denominators alone so that ends up being 15. And when you're doing these, you always want to check at the end to make sure it's reduced. And so you look at the 22 and the 15 to see if anything will divide evenly into both of them. And we find that that's not the case for this particular problem. Back a long time ago, you might have switched this particular answer into a mixed number. Now that we're in algebra, we prefer the improper fractions, so we would just leave it as 22 over 15. Now, that process is almost identical to our subtraction process, so let's take a look at a problem where we're subtracting. For instance, let's say that we have 7/8, and we're going to subtract from that 5/6. Our denominators do not match, so again, we're going to go ahead and take a look at what's the smallest thing that 8 and 6 go into. And this time, it's not the value you get when you multiply the denominators together. Up here, we multiplied the 3 times 5 and got our 15. But down here, if you multiply 8 and 6, you get 48, and that's not the smallest thing that both of them go into. Because I noticed that 8 goes into 24, and 6 also goes into 24. So we're actually going to build these up to 24 rather than 48. 48 would have worked fine, but you'd have to reduce your answer at the end. And to save us that step, we'll build it up to 24. Now, to make the 8 a 24, let's multiply it by 3, because 8 times 3 is 24. And if I multiply it by 3, I have to multiply my 7 by 3. And that gives me a new fraction of 21 over 24. Now, if we look at our next fraction, 6 times 4 is 24, so I'll multiply this 6 by 4 in order to build it up to the 24. So that's going to give me a 6 times 4 here, but if I multiply that by 4, I have to multiply the 5 by 4. And that builds this second fraction up into 20 over 24. Now our denominators match, so we can just subtract our numerators and get 1 over 24. Now, there's one little change that we could make in the subtraction problem, and it's something that we will do with the rational expressions. It wasn't as necessary in this problem because we had numbers, and the numerator just had one item, just the 5 over here, which turned into just one item, which is the 20. However, with rational expressions, you may have more than one term in the numerator, and the subtraction here is going to apply to all of them. So there's a little rule we're going to apply, which is that subtraction is the same thing as adding the opposite of what's after it. That makes it so this goes to plus, and this 5 turns from positive to negative. So we distribute the subtraction across the numerator of the fraction that's right after it. And if you take a look, the 21 plus a negative 20 still gives us the 1. But doing that little step with our expressions is going to make it so that we have less of a chance of having a error based on positive and negatives, which are very common errors to make. Now let's go ahead and look at some rational expressions. We're going to start out with some that are dealt with almost identical to what we just did. However, the other ones will not necessarily be done in this manner. The reason why these are slightly different is because if you look at them, we're going to do 5 over 2xy squared minus 7 over 3x cubed y. And if you look at them, the reason why these will be slightly different and the process will be closer to what we just did is because the new denominators are just monomials. There's only one term in this denominator. And over here, there's only one term. So these ones will be dealt with almost identical to the ones we just did. And we will be able to just look at them and find the common denominator. However, since there are numbers and letters, I like to break this into little parts by first looking at the numbers, then looking at each letter separately. So let's go ahead and first apply our subtraction rule. So we're going to add the opposite of our 7, distributing the subtraction to the top of this fraction following the subtraction sign. And then we're going to look at the numbers to start. I have a 2 and a 3. The smallest thing those both go into is 6. So I need to build each of them up to a 6. I'm going to do that in the first one by multiplying the top and bottom by 3. And in the second one by multiplying the top and bottom by 2. Now I'm going to look at the letters. Starting with the x's. This is an x to the first, because when there's no exponent, it's an implied 1. And this is an x cubed. We can't reduce an exponent down unless there's something in the numerator to cancel with it. But we can build it up. So what we want to do is figure out which variable has the highest exponent and build the other one up to it. So the highest one is this 3 here. So I need to build the 1 up to a 3. And when you multiply variables, you add the exponents. So I need to multiply this term by an x squared to make the 1 here go up to match the 3 that's over here. So I'm going to multiply top and bottom here by x squared. That takes care of my x's. So let's look at the y's. So this one's a y squared, and this one's a y to the first. So I need to build the y to the first up so that it matches the y squared. So if I multiply this by y, it'll turn into a y squared. So the top and bottom here, I'll get multiplied by a y. That changes your first fraction into 15x squared over 6x cubed y squared. Plus, and over here, 2 times negative 7 times y is a negative 14y. And my denominator matches my first one of 6x cubed y squared. Now, the denominators match, so we can go ahead and add the numerators. And so this becomes 15x squared. And you could do plus negative 14y or just a minus 14y. They're not like terms, so you have to leave them separate like that. And then the denominator is just 6x cubed y squared. Now, we always want to see if we can reduce. So I'm going to look at the numerator here and see if there's a common factor. And there isn't, so I can't factor anything out to cancel with the denominator. So we would say that this entire expression here is complete, and this would be your answer to this problem. Now, let's just build our problems up slightly larger than what we had here. Let's say we have something like 5 over x plus 3 plus 7 over x plus 2. Now, some of you might be looking at this and going, well, let's just go ahead and add 1 to this denominator, and it'll match the first one over here. Because this is an x plus 3, and that's an x plus 2, it just needs one more. The problem is you have to multiply to build your fractions up. You can't add to do it. So we need to take a look at this, and what you want to do is, I like to, when I see something like this, go right ahead and put parentheses around each denominator. So we look at it as if it's a factor. And I check and see if I can actually factor the denominators, but x plus 3 and x plus 2 are already factored. So I take a look at this and I ask myself, I say, okay, this one has an x plus 3, this one has an x plus 2. This one needs an x plus 2 to match the x plus 2 over here. So I'm going to give it what it's missing that the other fraction has. And to do that, I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by an x plus 2. And then I ask myself, okay, what is this fraction missing in the denominator that this one has? Well, this one has the x plus 2 now because we gave it to it, but it does not have the x plus 3. So I need to give this one the x plus 3 that the other one has. So I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by x plus 3. Now, both denominators have both factors, and it doesn't matter what order the factors are in as long as they have all of them. So I need to go ahead and add these, but order of operations requires that you multiply before you add. So notice in the numerators up here that we have a 5 times an x plus 2. We need to distribute this and multiply it out before we can add, because order of operations requires you multiply before you add. Similarly, over here, this 7 needs to be distributed in order to be able to add it, because you have to multiply first. So let's go ahead and distribute on the top of both of those fractions. 5 times x gives us a 5x. And 5 times 2 gives us a 10. And our denominator is x plus 3 times x plus 2. And again, it doesn't matter what order the denominators are in as long as all the factors are there. Now for our second one, 7 times x is 7x. And 7 times 3 is 21. So this gives us x plus 3 times x plus 2 in the denominator, with a 7x plus 21 in the numerator. Our denominators now match. They both have both factors. So we can go ahead and add these, and we do that by adding like terms. So we're going to add our 5x and our 7x, which is going to give us a 12x. And then we're going to add our 10 and our 21, which is going to give us a 31. And then the denominator stays as an x plus 3 times an x plus 2. Now you want to check and see if you can reduce. So you take a look at the numerator here, and there is nothing in common with the 12x and the 31, so we can't factor anything out to cancel with the denominator. So we just leave our answer as this entire expression right here. Let's take a look at one that's just slightly larger than this. Let's say